One of the most popular and commonly used functions in Excel is the if function. A lot of people struggle though, you may be one of them. There's only actually three parts you need to know, and once you understand how those three parts fit together, if functions become easy. So I'm going to lift the lid on this function, I'm going to show you lots of examples, and if you're struggling with if, stay tuned. So here's how the if function works. You need to come up with some sort of question, a single question, or a test, or a condition. If the result of that condition is true, you do this. If the result of that condition that you're testing is false, you do that. So you have one question, but two possible outcomes. So let's take a simple example, an everyday example. You want to decide whether to take your umbrella to work, or whether to take your sunglasses to work. So you ignore the weatherman on TV, because they just guess it anyway. What you do is you look outside the window, and you go, is it cloudy? Is it raining? Is it going to rain? If it is, take an umbrella. If it's not, take your sunnies. So again, one question, two possible outcomes. So here I'm just going to put, to start off with, the word rain. And that's what we're going to be checking for with our if statement. To write the if statement, you start with equals if, open the brackets. And if you know what you're doing, you can actually just follow that screen tip through. And there's three parts to your formula. The test, as in what you're testing. What happens if it's true? What happens if it's false? If you want to click the FX here, it gives you a box which breaks it down, makes it a little bit easier. So what I'm going to do here for my logical test is to say this cell, is it equal to rain? And I put rain in quotes because it's text. Value if true says take an umbrella. I'm just going to tab down. Notice how the quote marks have been added around the text. It does that automatically in the box. If it's not true, take your sunnies. So two possible outcomes, one question. So based on the fact it currently says rain, it says take an umbrella. If the weather is sunny, the result of the if function says take your sunnies. Okay, that's one example. In Australia, once a year, we have a competition, a rugby competition called State of Origin. State against state, mate versus mate. Now you're either a Queenslander or a New South Wales supporter. So your question might be, are you a Queenslander? If so, go the Maroons. If you're not, go the Blues. So let's say the question is going to be, is the state Queensland? So our if function says, equals if. Again, I'm going to click the FX here to break it down. The test is this cell equal to Queensland? If it is, go the Maroons. Otherwise, go the Blues. All right, so again, one question, two outcomes. Okay then. So while it says Queensland, it says go the Maroons. If I change that to anything other than Queensland, actually, it then says go the Blues. Okay, let's do one more example. So let's say a salesperson has done a really good job and they've generated $250,000 worth of sales. We're going to introduce, first of all, just a single level if function that says, is this sales figure greater than $200,000? If it is, the commission is 10% of that sales figure. Just a straightforward 10% multiplied by the figure. That's the sales commission. Otherwise, zero for now. So we click OK. Based on the fact that they've done really well, $250,000 of sales, their commission is 10% of that, $25,000. Pretty good payday. But if they only made less than $200,000, at this stage, they get nothing at all. You can take that a stage further. And what you do is, let's go back to the original if function. Instead of just saying zero here, you can introduce a second if function with a second test. So my second test is going to be, is this value greater than 100,000? Now what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to write it out all in one box, but you'll see the final formula and I'll explain it there. So if it's greater than 100,000, then the commission is 5% times the sales figure. If it's not greater than 100,000, as in it's less or equal to, I'm going to say zero again. So I'm going to close the brackets there and click OK. So what we have at the top here is a two-level if function. And basically what we're saying is, test the figure first of all, is it greater than 200,000? If it is, apply the 10% commission. Otherwise, if it's not greater than 200,000, do a second test, and this time test, is it greater than 100,000? If that's true, apply a 5% commission, otherwise nothing. We're just coming down from the top, asking first of all, are the sales greater than 200,000? If so, pay 10% commission. Otherwise, do a second check and say, is it greater than 100,000? If that's true, pay 5%. Otherwise, pay nothing. You can also keep on going with that as long as you want to as many levels as you want to. But it does get a little bit complicated, and there are better ways to do that when you get to that point.